Hello and welcome to Tech Circle. Today we are in conversation with Nitin Chhabra, CEO of Ace Turtle. We'll begin now with, you speaking about how smooth or challenging, the whole digital transformation journey has been during this period of pandemic.
See, for us, to be honest, so there are two parts to it, right? One is, how we work. I think that changed, definitely. And the second part was on the business side, right? How it, contributed to our business. So let me take up the one, how it changed. So how it essentially changed for us because it was new way of working. So though of course it was slightly easier for us because we're largely a tech company. So that became easier for us to, operate, remotely. But I think there were other issues, for example, granting access onto, some of our secure environments to, our team members who are gonna work remotely, etc. But I think that was an easier part. I think the little bit of challenging part was that when the new members were joining in, the knowledge transfer to those new members. Because end of the day, when you have documentation can only give you so much. It doesn't give you the context. So I think these are some of the things which we, had challenges around. And then what we did was we started doing some short videos, arranging one-on-one conversations between, the new team members to, handle that kind of a piece. So I think it was, I would say a bit challenging for us, but not very difficult for us, considering we're largely a tech company. So it was not too much of a challenge. On the business side, I think it was fantastic for us. On the business side, it gave us a lot of tailwinds. So omni-channel from, being a boardroom discussion and a roadmap actually became a rollout. So there we had a very different problem because, typically clients would take a couple of months to take a decision and their implementation plan would be put into place. But in this scenario, everybody wanted to go live tomorrow, right? So we had the issue of having so many clients to go live suddenly and everybody wants, the first priority. So I think those were some of the issues which we had to handle from a product side. Which we did it, how can we, make the onboarding auto so that even the non-technical teams can onboard new clients. So these were some of the things, I would say, which happened during this challenging times. But definitely it gave a business, tailwinds, no doubt about it.
So Ace Turtle used to be a tech platform for offline stores earlier. So how did it, how did you change your product to cater to online businesses of offline brands, and how long did it all take?
See, we're not really changed. We just, added a new vertical. So for us, SaaS vertical was our core. You're absolutely right. Before the pandemic, and then what happened was that during the pandemic, because of the tailwinds we got, we grew about 5.5x over the previous year. And and then as boards do, they are supposed to demand more. And I think we all got a bit greedy to say, okay, can we continue to grow 5x for the next 3 to 4 years? So we said, okay, if we have to maintain that kind of a growth, then we have to look at some of we have to look at some inorganic ways of growing faster. So one of the ways we thought would be because we saw a lot of heritage brands which were in the market, great brands having great equity, great salience among the Indian consumer, but largely there were some challenges they were facing because the landscape has changed for commerce because now it's more about technology. It's more about the consumer wanting to shop whenever the consumer wants, however the consumer wants. So I think a lot of these great brands were having some challenges to adapt to this new commerce environment. And then we thought, that's an opportunity for us because if you look at our kind of a model on the SaaS model, we get a very tiny, tiny piece of the GMV. So we said, okay, now if we take over some of these brands ourselves and through technology, we just don't bring in scalability and engagement on the front-end side, which is a consumer-facing side, but also bring in a lot of efficiencies on the back-end side, which is supply chain side. So that's what we decided to do so that we can get a much larger portion of GMV. And that's how the model changed. So on the front-end side, there was no change really because we were anyways, large brands were using us anyways for that omni-channel tech for the front-end. But on the supply chain side, we did make a few changes. And to be honest, quite a few changes are still going on because there's a whole new roadmap now which we've added on the supply chain. And when I'm saying supply chain, because now with these brands, whether we talk about Lee, Wrangler, Toys R Us or Babies R Us, these are the four we publicly announced and there are a couple of more coming soon. So what we did was that we said, okay, how can we look at the entire process in the back end, right from design all the way up to, till it hits a stock point like a retail store or a warehouse. So we in Rubicon, which is our, omnichannel platform, we also have one of the modules, which is the catalog management system. And in that module, we actually capture all the attributes like you do in a catalog, right? You will be capturing, okay, this is the color of the t-shirt, the short sleeves, this kind of a fit and this kind of a style, etc. Because you capture all those attributes anyways in the catalog. So now that's already there with us. Now we also have our inventory for the brand, which we are licensees for. We already have the inventory data. We already have the fulfillment data and sales data. So we know what the customer is liking and we know the attributes. So we know what kind of product is, in trend right now or is being favored most by the consumers right now. So we harness that data and we are pushing it into our supply chain. So that so what we have done right now is we have now the ability to harness the data to use it. The next leg, which is how to make sure that, because one, to be honest, being a tech company for us, harnessing data is the easier part. But the most complicated part is how to make the factories, which are used to working in a certain way, to actually produce in a much more agile way. Yeah. So that's the piece which we are working on with these factories. So we, we were very pleased to, it was great news for us when most of the existing factories actually agreed to upgrade their systems. Because to connect into their systems, they needed to have APIs. So some of them are upgrading, their systems so that through those APIs, we connect our platform. So we capture the demand and then we push it on supply chain so that the entire supply chain becomes far more agile. So that's, the roadmap which we are on right now. So it's going to take us another 7 to 8 months to, be completely, to completely achieve what we set out in phase one.
Has there been any retail strategy that you have been following?
Yeah, see, we have always followed the same thing to say that, bring in efficiency and scalability through tech. Because tech can solve a lot of things. Just to give you an example, for some of these brands which we spoke about, which we have taken over, which we're calling it in the captive brands vertical, is where we said, a traditional way of even running the retail operation, because so far we were never involved in the offline retail operations. We would only give our tech to them, right? But this is now because since we are a long-term licensees of these brands for the country, so we said, okay, how do we now digitize those operations as well? Because end of the day, how traditionally retail organizations are set up, you have a retail manager who visits the store, right? Whatever checklist or whatever interaction they have, they capture it, give it to the regional manager. Regional manager gives it to the national manager. And the national manager then gives it to the function, which is actually going to execute. So in today's time, you don't need it, right? You can connect these stores directly to your platform. And through data itself, you can get to know what's exactly going on in the store, what exactly they need. They can connect with you much faster. So what we did was we removed all those layers. So there are no regional offices, which we have now. There is no supervisors who are going to go to the stores. Everything is being data driven and the stores are connected 24/7 to our platform in real time. So I think that's one big change which we have done, which is new to the industry. But a lot of our clients on the SaaS platform saw this. Now they are also taking this product also from us.
Can you also name some of the large brands you are catering to?
See, we are working with the Landmark Group. Landmark Group has Lifestyle, Max, Home Center. We are working with Luxottica, their brand Ray-Ban. We are working with the Fossil Group. They have multiple brands like Fossil, Skagen, Armani watches and so on. We are working with the brands of Kering Group, which is on the eyewear side, which will be your Gucci, YSL, Bottega Veneta, and so on. Then we work with brands like Pepe, Fila, and so on. So we largely work with lifestyle brands, but who have a certain scale. For our right kind of brands for us would be, brands who have at least about 100 odd stores and are operating through multiple channels. So that's where, our platform is able to deliver much more value to them.
Okay. And how many deals did you sign for the omnichannel customer offering?
SaaS, I think we would have got about 24 brands during the pandemic. What I was talking about is we don't work with all the brands or not all the brands would be, we would be relevant for them. We work with brands which have a certain size, like I was telling you, which are working across multiple channels, who have at least 100 plus stores. So we work with those kind of brands only. So about 24 odd brands on the SaaS side. On the captive brands, these are the four we've announced, which is Lee, Wrangler, Toys R Us, and Babies R Us. All four were operating in India. We took over their businesses, and now hopefully we're going to announce another, make another announcement in the next couple of months on the captive brand side. On the SaaS side, I think two to three brands are getting added every month on a run rate basis.
Mm-hmm. And what are the current growth numbers?
See, 5.5x was the growth, on the SaaS platform over last year. Captive brands, it was that vertical was not there last year, so we don't have, the comparables. But we expect in 2 years' time, the captive brand vertical to become bigger than the SaaS vertical.
Okay, and what are the growth projections like, say, 12 to 14 months? And
the idea is, again, both verticals put together should continue to give us about 5x of growth over the next 3 to 4 years.